The Imperial Forgy has been invaded by Takeed, the Prince of Darkness. Only the owners of the magic bells can stop his forces from destroying the realm. Led by the mountaineering youth Samson, a force of unlikely heroes sets out to banish evil forever. Become a fire-breathing dragon, a living statue of solid stone, or a nimble and crafty mouse. Soar the skies and belch fireballs as Kikira the Dragon Lord. Crush enemy troops with fists of granite as Gam the Rock Lord. Scurry past dangerous monsters while setting time bombs as K.O. the Mouse. These creatures join Little Samson to form a unique and powerful alliance as the last hope for the Imperial Forgy. In Little Samson, from Taito, released in 1992, really close to the end of the NES's lifespan. I love this game, viewers. This is such a great game. Imagine, if you will, the G.I. Joe game that lets you pick your teams and swap people in and out. Imagine that. But then make it a Mega Man game. Kind of. Make it more linear, more stage-based, no choose-your-own-path kind of stuff, but just combine those two elements, and you have got an amazingly fun and challenging game in Little Samson. The game's name in Japan loosely translates to Lickle, Legend of the Holy Bell. This was released at the height of platform gaming success, hopefully to finally achieve a solid hit on a system with a proven formula, the way Hudson had done with Adventure Island and Capcom had with Mega Man. However, the game did not sell well upon release and is today completely unknown to a lot of gamers. It's notable for having highly detailed graphics for an 8-bit game and seen in the game's menacing boss characters, which really, really contrast heavily with the more childlike sprites of the protagonists. Yeah, the bosses are scary. Throughout the game, we operate one of the four characters, each with their own strengths and weaknesses, so we've kind of got a little RPG-ish kind of thing there. The first four stages of the game are dedicated to a specific character, but upon their completion, the player can swap characters at any time for the remainder of the game, and often must do so in order to complete a level. We get to pick from Little Samson, who the game is named for. He's a young human protagonist. He's small, quick, and attacks enemies by throwing bells. He's able to jump higher and further than most characters and has the ability to climb on walls and ceilings. Kikira, the dragon, is the second hero. As a dragon, she has the ability to fly for brief periods of time, making her a valuable character in many of the jumping-oriented stages. She attacks by spitting fire, which travels in an upward arc, and the player can increase the strength of the fire by holding down the B button for longer periods of time. We have Gam the Golem, who is big and bulky. He is the slowest of all three, but his punch is stronger than any of the other characters' attacks. His size is both a benefit, as he takes the least damage from enemy attacks and no damage from spikes, and also starts with more health than everybody else, and a hindrance because his jumping ability is severely stunted. He is also the only character who can attack in all four directions, up, down, left, and right. We have K.O. the Mouse as the final hero. K.O. has the least health of everybody, but he is very, very quick and an amazing jumper, and he is smaller than everyone, so he can traverse some narrow passages that are otherwise inaccessible. Just like Samson, he has the ability to climb walls and ceilings and is unique in that he attacks by placing bombs, which can be a great help in some of the boss fights, as is Gam's super strong punch. We have a pretty basic story. The Dark Prince is freed from his seal by a thunderstorm and begins to try to take over the world. The kingdom is in peril, and the king orders that the four heroes receive a summon. Four pigeons fly off to meet these heroes. Each reads the summon. From here, we have to navigate all four of the players through an introductory course back to the castle. From here, the strengths of the individual characters must be utilized to get through a variety of courses. Several bosses await the heroes, and it's up to our strategy to choose which hero or heroes will fight the boss. A few levels have branching exits, taking the player to different levels, although each one ends up taking the player to stages marked by skulls on the map. Here, the player fights one of the four wizards that serve as the Dark Prince's right-hand men, each of which becomes a larger boss when defeated. A cyclops, a knight, a dragon, and a grim reaper. Eventually, the player reaches what appears to be the Dark Prince's castle and faces a golden wizard knight at the end, which transforms into a giant skull. If the game is played on easy, this is the final level. If played on normal, the Dark Prince's true stronghold, a castle resting on a giant green skull, arises, and the game continues for a few more levels, ending with a confrontation with the Dark Prince himself. Little Samson is fairly unique in, though, although there is an established storyline, there's not a single line of dialogue spoken or written in the entire game. All story development is shown through pantomime animated cutscenes. This approach was also used in the Mega Drive Sonic the Hedgehog series, generally in the final stages of the game, but more frequently in Sonic the Hedgehog 3, which was released after Little Samson. The gameplay is very reminiscent of Mega Man. Player jumps with A, we attack with B. Character's health is shown by a series of bars stacked vertically on the left side. Throughout the stages, characters must defeat enemies and avoid pits while collecting standard power-ups like 1-ups, hearts for health, increasing our health capacity, and a potion which lets us refill our health. Two choices of gameplay, easy and normal. Obviously difficulty level. Normal mode, we get more changes. Characters will have a limit on how much their health meter may extend, which is about half of what it is in easy mode. Levels will also sport more enemies in normal mode, and should a player die with either the dragon, golem, or mouse, that character will no longer be selectable until the player either uses a potion or beats the level. Little Samson, on the other hand, will always be playable, and because of which, he can complete almost all the levels alone, exceptions being the introductory levels and the very last level. A unique feature of the game is that the player can switch characters at any point during the level, similar to G.I. Joe. Each character has their own health gauge, but they all share the same lives. The unique setup makes the game stages much more easy to complete than many other similar games, and allows for unique strategies when facing the game's boss characters, which the player must face at the end of most of the stages. When confronted, the boss's health is displayed in a similar fashion to the player's, but on the opposite side of the screen. There are two kinds of bosses, regular bosses and the Dark Prince's henchmen. Normal bosses consist of one fight against a creature, Samson and company encounter along the way, and a henchman boss consists of two phases, their cloaked form and the boss's true form. And after defeating each boss, we get a password. It is an incredibly fun game, viewers. It is so sad to me that not a lot of people know this game, because I think if more people knew it, they would just love it. This is a fantastically fun game, and if you've never played it, you really owe it to yourself to try. If you're not sure you want to, there is a full Let's Play of this over at the Low Bias Gaming website. And you should probably check it out if this interested you even just a little bit.